Coming up, hockey star Mike Fisher on his sport, his faith, and his marriage to Carrie Underwood.
It's been huge because there's different pressures of different type of media, your relationships, kind of a little bit of the spotlights. A couple that prays together stays together. I love that because that's so true.
We'll hit the ice with the Nashville Center on today's 700 Club Interactive. On 700 Club Interactive, we use technology to pray for each other and explore topics that matter to you. Watch what God is doing in the world today. Welcome to the show. Mike Fisher is a hockey star playing for the Nashville Predators, while his wife, Carrie Underwood, is one of the most successful country singers of all time. Their busy schedules and celebrity lifestyles could be a recipe for disaster, but they found a secret ingredient in their marriage, faith.
Nashville Predators forward Mike Fisher has been described as one of the most aggressive players in the NHL. Also known as Fish, the newly married husband of country star Carrie Underwood made his pro debut with the Ottawa Senators in 1999. But his vigorous reputation on the ice began much earlier, when he was a kid simply trying to defend his faith.
I got made fun of when I was a kid, especially playing hockey, maybe a little bit at school, and I can remember countless times of a few times missing practices or whatever to go to church, and especially at a young age, and kids didn't understand that, and they would, throw the Bible basher jokes and things like that.
Mike grew up in a Christian home in Peterborough, Ontario.
I just still remember that day and hearing the message of Christ and wanting to accept Him as my Savior. So I still remember going into my bed, kneeling down with my mom, and she kind of led the prayer and led me to the Lord.
Mike started playing hockey competitively when he was 7. And from the moment he touched the ice, he felt as though he had something to prove, especially because the other kids thought that because he was a church boy, he wouldn't be aggressive enough.
I wanted to play as hard as I can and prove to people that I could be a Christian. I could play like even Mark Osborne or Stu Grimson, who played for Nashville. He's a fighter and a guy that was very scary, but a solid Christian guy.
Mike developed into a stellar athlete, and at the age of 18, he was drafted by the Ottawa Senators. And like many young pro athletes, life in the sport became his world, and it was hard for him to keep his priorities in order.
Kind of became a little bit of my God, and I still a Christian, but I wasn't really where I needed to be, and I wasn't living in the Spirit. For a period of time, I got too focused on hockey, and that kind of led me astray a little bit.
Mike's career soared, but he realized he needed to refocus on his relationship with Jesus Christ.
At about 22, when I got settled in Ottawa, is when I kind of said, okay, that's enough. I need to start focusing. God's given me this unique gift. I'm living a dream here. I got to start focusing on Him and using those gifts and sharing it with others.
Mike was committed to just that for 12 seasons with the Senators, making it to the postseason all but the last two. Then in 2011, he was traded to Nashville. But just before he left Ottawa, he made one more commitment with his marriage to Carrie.
A little over a year ago, you let Jesus take the wheel. How has your faith helped you all stay planted and keep your feet on the ground?
Well, it's been huge because there's different pressures of different type of media, your relationships, kind of a little bit of the spotlights. Putting that into perspective and just trying to work on our relationship, keep everything outside and try and keep the Lord in the center of it. When He's there, everything's so much easier. And a couple that prays together stays together. I love that because that's so true.
Mike continues to serve as a beacon of light in a game that can sometimes call for the tough and gritty style of play that Mike brings to the ice every day. In his new book, Defender of Faith, he wants to encourage kids to be bold about their faith wherever God leads them.
I want them to just stand up, be able to be proud of their faith and not be scared of it. It's something to be definitely proud of and be able to share it, and whatever God's gifted with you or whatever, just go after it. Put the Lord at the center of it. And there's no way to peace and happiness like the Lord can bring. And that's exciting because it's free. You don't have to go out and earn it. You just got to accept it.
You don't have to earn it. You just have to accept it. You just have to receive it. And how do you do that? Because all of that grace can literally overwhelm you because you start thinking, oh, I'm not worthy of that. I'm not worthy that God would love me, that he would care for me, that he would put me on a path to him. Well, it's the wonderful thing is that God loves you and he made you unique in the universe to have a relationship with him. And he so wants it that he's willing to do anything to have it. And all we have to do is believe that good news. That's all we have to do. And here you see Mike Fisher, top of his profession, got fame, got fortune. But he's saying the most important thing for me is my relationship with Jesus Christ. You can do the same thing. And all you have to do is call on him. Whether you're raised in a Christian home or not, it's a real simple prayer. Jesus, if you're there, if this is real, if you really love me, could you show me? Could you be my Savior? Could you show up for me? And if you pray that with all of your heart, he'll be there for you. He'll come. The Bible says, when you seek me with all of your heart, then you'll find me. If you want someone to pray with you, we've got people standing by that would just love to do that. We're not here to condemn you. We're not here to judge you. What we're here to do is just tell you God loves you, and he wants to be with you, and he wants to be your Savior today. Number's on the screen. It's toll-free, 888-777-1999. Well, still ahead, children as young as 11 are having children of their own, and see how they've been given a home and a hope for the future.
I started feeling pain between my spine and my shoulder blade. All I had was pain and no relief. There was a sizable mass consistent with a malignant cancer in upper right lung. And that's complex, that's tough stuff. I was walking, talking, but I didn't know how sick I was.
I remembered seeing the ad for Cancer Treatment Centers of America, and I thought, this is the place he needs to be.
To find out more about Cancer Treatment Centers of America and our unique treatment options for complex and advanced stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com. You'll be able to see our treatment results for many types of cancers and how they compare to national averages. You can also check for participating insurance plans.
The game plan was chemotherapy and radiation throughout the whole period. It was an aggressive plan of attack. I liked that.
We gave him chemotherapy and radiation. He was an amazing patient. He tolerated treatment exceptionally well.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is different. You feel it the moment you call or walk into one of our hospitals. It's state-of-the-art medicine, unique treatment options, and a level of compassion that cannot be copied. Why? Our people. People who give you not only their expertise, but their humanity, and the most thoughtful, well-organized, patient-centered care you'll find anywhere.
My strength came back. I began to become myself again.
George does have his life back now. He has a life that I never thought he was gonna have.
With the teamwork, the treatment plans, the facilities, the combination of all the aspects of the treatment, I'm so happy that I went to CTCA.
Every minute counts when you're fighting complex or advanced stage cancer. So please call or visit cancercenter.com today. Appointments are available now. Cancer Treatment Centers of America, care that never quits.
The girl you're about to meet had a bad temper and a bad habit of lying until she received a lesson that changed her life.
Ijoma lives with her parents and brothers in Jos, Nigeria. Her father's a professor and her mother teaches at a local Christian school. But growing up in a Christian home didn't stop Ijoma from slipping up occasionally.
I used to shout at my brothers because they make me angry. And I used to lie so that I won't be punished. I felt God felt bad and sad with me.
Lectures from her mother didn't change Ijoma's behavior.
So we prayed, trusting God that there would be a change.
Right around that time, Ijoma's school started using a vacation Bible school kit, Superbook DVDs, and other materials provided by CBN. The program taught the kids about trusting in Jesus and living a godly life. The classes helped Ijoma realize that God didn't want her to have a bad attitude.
Even though our sins are much, God can still forgive us.
Ajorma started being nice not just to her brothers, but everyone around her.
Anytime I wanted to shout at my brothers or lie, Jesus would tell me not to. The lesson I learned from the summer school has also helped me to change the life of other children.
Ajorma is one of many children whose lives have been touched by Superbook and other resources produced and provided by CBN.
Thank you, CBN.
That episode she watched was from the original Superbook series, which was it was produced originally just for Japan back in the early 1980s. And here we are, you know, so many years later. I mean, you have three decades. It's still being broadcast throughout Africa and changing lives. And we're advancing the technology. We want to have a whole new version of the Superbook series done with modern animation to reach the children of the world with the good news, to let them know the stories of the Bible in a way that's entertaining, that they like to watch and they get the message and their lives can be changed. Our goal over the next 5 years is for 300 million children to see Superbook. We're getting ready to release the first 13 episodes. We've already produced 9 of them. And we're getting ready to get it translated into 38 different languages. We'll launch it out in the Philippines, and you can be a part of it. How? What we're asking you to do is give to the production cost of the episodes. And for a gift of $25 or more, we'll send you the latest episode, which is The Miracles of Jesus. So if you want to be a part of it, call us 888-777-1999 or log on to CBN.com. You can also join the Superbook DVD Club to make sure you're going to be part of all the episodes. And every time a new episode is released, we'll send it out to you along with not just one, but 3 copies of the episode so you can share it with your friends, your family, with your church. Schools. It's incredible how children love this and they want to watch it. So we want to get the message out. We want to get the gospel out. But we need your help to do it. So if you want to be a part of it, call us 888-777-1999 or you can log on to CBN.com. On the internet, you can also get caught up if you this is all new to you and you want to get the first 8 episodes. There's a way you can do that on the website. So call us. Be part of it. Also, CBN will be broadcasting 2 Superbook episodes over the Thanksgiving holiday. If you want to watch those, all you have to do is tune in to ABC Family Channel, 9:30 a.m. Eastern and Western Time. Central Time will be 8:30. That's on November 22nd, November 23rd. Children will be home, and we want to make sure they get an access to it. We'll also be doing a very special broadcast during the Christmas season as well, so stay tuned for that. Well, coming up, find out how an infertile woman became a mother because of a phone call right after this.
It was one of the gutsiest plays ever made in the NFL. It changed the momentum of Super Bowl 44, and the Saints won their first ever Super Bowl championship. Chris Reese's recovery of an onside kick may have been the most famous in Super Bowl history, but it would come to mean even more to his father who sat watching in the stands. Their lives as father and son would change forever that day. Hear their story on the 700 Club next.
If you're the mother of a child with behavior problems, I'd like to talk to you. My name is Janet Lehman, and I'm a behavioral therapist and a mom. I know what it's like when the child that you love becomes a defiant, out-of-control child who disrespects you.
That's why my husband James and I created the Total Transformation, the program that tens of thousands of moms are now using to turn around their child's behavior.
If you've heard about the Total Transformation and wondered if it will work for you, now you can try it for free. I'm willing to give away 1,000 programs today for free.
All you need to do is get the program and let us know how it works for you. We'll let you keep it for free.
I know the Total Transformation works because I used these techniques with my own son and with troubled kids for over 30 years. Let me prove to you that it works by giving you the program free.
Call the number on your screen now to get the Total Transformation free.
Hello? Is this thing on? Hey, kids, do you love games? Yeah! And do you love creating characters? Yeah! do you love discovering things?
Yeah!
Well, do ya?
Yeah!
Then you're gonna love the new Superbook.tv! Ouch! Superbook.tv. A fun new way to learn about the Bible.
Okay, this is 700 Club Interactive. This is the show where we interact with you. And so we've got a chat question coming in from Josiah. So let's go over to Lakeisha, find out what it is.
Josiah says, I've been a Christian for most of my life, but one thing has me confused. Should we go to God with a particular prayer just once and have the faith he would answer? Or is it okay if we ask God repeatedly to answer a prayer?
Let me refer you to Luke chapter 11, where Jesus gives examples of prayer. And first, he starts off with the Lord's Prayer. And then he starts talking about the unrighteous judge and how a widow came to him and kept knocking and kept inquiring. And then he told another parable about someone who had a visitor come and stay with them. They didn't have any food for them, but they knew a neighbor. And so they went and knocked on the door, and he said, go away. I'm in bed already with my children. And because of the persistence of the knocking, he got up, and the request was answered. And then he said, knock and seek, you'll find. If you knock, it'll be opened unto you. If you seek, you will find. And the Greek on those words is a continual thing. It's a continual knocking. It's a continual seeking. So it's called perseverance in prayer. So if you don't get the answer, keep on praying. Now, I'll add to this that faith is an act. And sometimes I've seen in just the prayers that people don't believe. They don't believe God's going to answer. And so you can literally hear the unbelief in the prayer. Be assured, that kind of prayer doesn't get an answer. If you're double-minded in prayer, it won't get an answer. Be assured that if you pray in accordance with his will, he hears, and if he hears, it will happen. So prayers where you have to argue with God, prayers where you have to convince God to heal the sick, or you have to convince God to perform the promises he's already made in the Bible, I don't go along with those. Keep seeking, keep knocking, keep praying. Well, we've got an incredible story about answers to prayer. Nicole Piazza dreamed of becoming a mother, and she kept praying for it. However, a surgical procedure threatened her chances of pregnancy. And then she took her mother's advice, made a phone call, and she'll never forget it.
What I thought was abnormal was that every month, I would mid-cycle start spotting. And it seemed like as the months would progress, it would get worse. The first incident, I guess, was back in March of 2004. It was my first surgery. Went to the doctors, they did ultrasound. They found that I had polyps growing in my uterus. So they were gonna do a polypectomy and a DNC. Even though I haven't been pregnant, I mean, they don't really like to do DNCs because it thins your uterus even more. But they did it lightly because I wanted to get pregnant eventually. About a year and a half later, same issue started again where I started spotting in between my cycle. Went back to the doctors, they were back again. So I had to have them removed again. I'm a very anxious person by nature. So I was extremely anxious again because I have to go through another surgery. And it's not just a surgery for me, but I have a blood clotting problem as well. So whenever I go through any type of surgery, there is a risk that I could throw a blood clot. So my mom watches Pat Robertson, and she had started watching Interactive. My mom had said, why don't you call into the show, and speak with Terry and Gordon. They'll pray for you. They're so blessed. And, you know, maybe you'll feel more at peace. And I said, okay. So I took a day off from work and I tried calling in, and actually I was able to get through on the first try.
And I just want you guys to pray that I have a peace about this, that I'm calm, because I get very nervous and anxious, that everything goes well with the anesthesia. And also I have a blood clotting problem, so it's always a little bit more risky when a surgery is involved.
He then proceeded, you know, they both actually prayed for me.
And we come against this root cause now in Jesus' name, and we say no more. No more polyps, no more growths, no more problems in Jesus' name.
And right afterwards, he said to me, you know, we never discussed anything during the call about ever having children. And he said to me, do you want children? And I said, yeah, of course I want children. And so he said, okay, well, are you married? And I said, yes, I am married. And I think he might have asked for how long, and I told him. He said, well, I want to pray for you right now.
And we just speak to Nicole now, the power to give life, the power to carry a child to term, that she will have the joy of holding her own child in her arms.
And then after he was done praying, he had just mentioned,
all right, Nicole, you gonna name him John?
And I said, yeah, sure. I was not surprised, I guess surprised in the sense that it happened so fast, like 1 month, and then it's, you know. And I called in and I said, I actually want to just give you guys a praise report that Gordon and Perry had prayed for me for my surgery afterwards that I would get pregnant. And I'm pregnant. And so we were like screaming on the phone, you know, going crazy. I said, but I'm calling you now because I'm a little bit scared with the pregnancy. I just want to pray and make sure that my blood's okay and that nothing happens. There also is a high risk of a terminated pregnancy, not because of the previous DNCs, but because of the blood clotting problem. So I was at risk of having a miscarriage. And they prayed a beautiful prayer over me and my husband. You know, I continued month by month, actually not worrying. You know, I never had in the back of my mind about, you know, having this blood condition and what could possibly happen. I read Psalm 91 every single night, like that was my scripture, even to this day. And I would anoint my belly with oil and just pray over my belly every single night and pray for the baby and just pray for myself. I think I was admitted into the hospital at 4 a.m. and I had the baby by 4:14 that night. Pushed for 45 minutes, I was able to have a natural delivery. My blood was normal. I never had a blood clot. So, and then come to find out, you know, we had a boy, and we did give him the middle name of Jonathan. God has been extremely faithful to us and our family, and he's blessed us in so many ways because I had so many issues, like with the polyps, with the blood issues. It just brings you to like a point in your life where sometimes you can't rely on yourself. You have to rely on someone else. And, you know, I have the Lord to go to. And no matter what, like, he's always there for me and for my family.
And he's always there for you. Understand that his love has no limits. And he's no respecter of persons. He loves you. He loves you infinitely. And he wants to provide good things for you. He wants to come to your aid. He wants to be your very present help in time of trouble. He wants to do all these things. And he ever lives to give intercession for you. Just start understanding Jesus is praying for you, that he's blessing you. He's sending angels to watch over you. He's doing all of these things because you're so unique and so precious for him. Now, what happened to Nicole can happen to you. You can get a miracle. You can have the supernatural come in, and regardless of what the doctors say, regardless of your worry, your fear, your anxiety, regardless of any of that, that love will penetrate all of that. Love never fails. He hasn't failed any of his promises. He's always come through. You can count on him. So we're going to pray now. Let that story encourage you. Let it give you faith. And don't look at your circumstance. Don't look at your symptoms. Don't look at all the terrible things that are going on. Don't look at that. Look to Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. Start understanding faith comes from him. When you look at the completed work on the cross, when he said, it's finished, look to him. not just on the cross, but look to him resurrected from the dead and understand that same resurrection power he wants to give to you. Look to him seated at the right hand of the Father, ever living to give intercession for who? For you. When you start understanding Jesus is praying for you, boy, you get all the faith you need. So, in an act of faith, if you need healing, just as Nicole needed protection for her unborn child, she would lay hands on her belly, she'd anoint her belly with oil. If you've got oil around, anoint yourself with oil, lay hands on that area of the body that needs healing. And we're going to agree. And the Bible says when two or more agree touching anything. So I'll agree with you. Lakeisha's here. She'll agree. If you don't have a prayer need in your life today, great. Join with us. Let's create a great circle of prayer and let's ask God to do miracles today. Let's pray. Lord, we just ask for the audience right now and for those who are hurting, for those that need healing, for those that need deliverance. Lord, you came to set the captives free. You came to heal the sick. You came for the brokenhearted. You came to forgive us of all our iniquity. And so we thank you for that. And we come into your presence with thanksgiving for what you're about to do for people today, how you're going to provide for them financially, how you're going to protect over their future, how you're going to be able to present them in your presence spotless with fullness of joy. And so we thank you for all of that and all that you've done. And now we say over these bodies, and we say it out loud, be healed now in Jesus' name and be every bit whole. We come specifically against cancer now. Leave this body. You have no power over it now. You must depart. You must dry up and go away. There's someone you're praying for your right shoulder. There's limited movement, deep pain in the socket. God's healing you right now. What you couldn't do before, do it now and realize you've been healed by Jesus Christ. By his stripes, you are healed now. There's someone else with recurring migraine headaches, and you're having one right now, and it's just left you. You're pain-free now in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you. We praise you. And we join with the psalmist and say, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who heals all our diseases, who forgives all of our iniquities, who renews our strength. Lord, we bless you now and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. If you need healing, if you need any answer to prayer, we're here for you. It's our honor to pray with you. So we want to stand with you in a prayer. So we're here for you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. All you got to do is pick up the phone. It's a toll-free call, 888-777-1999. Well, we've got some inbox questions. Lynn writes in, my 13-year-old is obsessed with celebrities. I think the whole culture is. She spends all her time reading about them, talking about them, dressing like them. Some people tell me it's just a phase. But it's been going on for a couple of years, and I can't get her interested in church. What can I do? Well, Lynn, I take advantage if she's interested in celebrities, find Christian celebrities and start talking about them. You know, we had a story earlier in the show about a Christian celebrity who is very prominent with their faith. And do that. Take what you think is leading her a wrong way to lead her back in. And you'll find, if you start looking, there are lots of Christian celebrities, so do that. Marilyn writes in, I was reading in Hebrews about God's rest. This scripture has always confused me. Can you tell me what it means? Hebrews, and you're talking specifically about chapter 3 and chapter 4, talk about entering into God's rest, and the way to do that is to believe. And understand there still awaits for God's people a rest. We look forward to the city whose builder and maker is God. And when we get there, we will have unbelievable rest. It's going to be great. There's also a rest right now when you just rest in faith and rest in his presence. The Apostle John talked about that. Don't be confused. Be reassured. It's all the time. We leave you this word from Proverbs. Commend yourself to instruction. Listen carefully to words of knowledge. God bless you. We'll see you again.